Hey, welcome back to my channel. Fancy seeing you guys here. Today we are going to talk about spray tans. I don't go in the sun. I feel like I say that every second, but I don't. I'm super, super scared of the sun. I'm a sunscreen psycho and I want to be tan at the same time. I think a good spray tan can make you look fabulous. So today we're going to talk about the breakdown of how I spray tan because I picked up all these little tips and tricks along the way that are essential. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Lauren Everts Bostic of The Skinny Confidential, which is a podcast, book, brand, and blog. So I'm going to break down my three spray tan tips, and how I'm going to do that is I'm going to tell you what to do before, what to do during, and what to do after. So before you spray tan, you have to take a shower. You can't not shower and go to the spray tan booth. So what I like to do is I like to work out an hour before I get a spray tan. So I'll do like the treadmill or strength training. Is it treadmill?
No.
How do you say it?
Treadmill.
Treadmill. I can't say that word. Like, let's just stick with my word. So I'll do like the treadmill, is that right?
Yeah.
I'll do the Bombshell Body Guide, strength training, whatever. And then I'll run, I'll take a shower, and I'll dry brush in the shower. I have a post on dry brushing on The Skinny Confidential. I'll leave the link below. It's amazing. It basically stimulates your circulation and just gives you like a really, really exfoliated glowing look. So I dry brush my entire body and shave. So you want to be fully exfoliated with the dry brush, and then you want to shave all the hair. After I do that, I towel off, really towel off a lot. I make sure that I don't have a manicure or pedicure because that's going to fuck it up and we don't want that. And then I head over to the spray tan booth. When I get there, I'm very specific about what I want. So I'm blonde and I feel like violet tones look the best on blondes. So I request violet tones, which at the place I go, it's called Island Kiss. And then I also like usually an accelerator, which makes the tan show up right away. Usually I'm running late, it's last minute, I have 5 seconds to spray tan, everyone's waiting on me, so I gotta go. So I do the accelerator, that makes it show up, like I said, right away. I mix the Island Kiss and the accelerator together, and then I go to the booth. The next step is really important. This is during the spray tan. So. This is like maybe gonna get a little creepy, but I'm just being really honest here about what I do. I take off all my jewelry. I have one bracelet that doesn't come off, so I just leave that on. I'm not gonna deal with that situation. And I put it in a pile. Then I put that ugly shower cap thing on my head because I wanna protect my hair. I like to spray tan my face. I just feel like it gives you a pretty glow and it works on me. I think you have to gauge who you are and what's gonna flatter your face most. For me, a spray tan kind of looks like I just went to the beach, even though I didn't. And if I was at the beach, I'd be wearing a ski mask, but that's a different story. So I put that ugly granny shower cap on, and then I take the small little towel that they give you, and I put it at the bottom of the booth. And the reason that I do that is because I don't want my feet to get spray tan on them. And this is where you can tell someone's spray tanned. If their feet have like that orange stuff at the bottom, you guys know what I'm talking about? Come on, everyone knows what I'm talking about, right? Sean says Lindsay Lohan, circa 2010, when she had her ankle bracelet and she set it off, I think, with kombucha. That's exactly what I'm talking about. But you don't want that shit on your feet. Like, you don't want to walk around, like, your house making spray tan marks, or, not that this happened to me, lay in bed with your husband and get orange shit all over the bed because it's all over your feet. It's just, like, not hot. So, again, I do the little towel at the bottom of the spray tan booth so I can stand on that the entire time. There's lots of different ways that you can prevent the orange from getting on the bottom of your feet, and I've tried all of them, and I'm telling you, the towel works the best. I don't use the barrier cream. The barrier cream is this cream that you can put on your nails. Instead, I do the claw hand. Does everyone know what the claw hand is? You know where you go like this, so you just like turn your nails in. And then for my toes, I just don't worry about that. We're gonna deal with that after. So I do the claw hand, I get in butt naked, so attractive, with my granny shower cap on, and I'm standing on my towel. So I go in front, I turn in back, I get all that done, I let it dry. I'm always wearing, too, a huge baggy dress when I do this because I don't wanna go put on tight jeans or tight leggings afterwards. I wanna throw in a trash bag. So it can dry really well. I should also mention that while I'm in the booth, I take my butt and stick it upwards so I don't get a crease in my butt. And then afterwards, I try not to look down a lot, which is hard because I basically work off my cell phone because it creases sometimes on your neck. So these are just like really random little tips and tricks that I found. Also, sometimes what do they call it, Ariel? What were
boob
you just
sweat.
Saying? You don't want your boob sweat to get underneath your tits. So like that's kind of hard
air
to
conditioning.
Avoid. Just like maybe fan them off, like have your boyfriend blow on them. I don't know, like whatever works for you here. So anyways, that's what I do during. Since a spray tan sometimes has chemicals in it most of the time, I do this weird thing where I leave the doors to the Mystic Reversa tan open so it can air out. So I'm just like leaving the doors open while I'm standing there butt naked. Not the door like to the booth, but the door to like the thing that you stand in. Does that make sense? Anyway, I leave the doors open because I want like the airflow to get in there. So my last and final tip, number 3, is what you do after. After I let like that blow dryer thing blow me dry, I get out and I actually don't use the towel. And the spray booth that I go in really dries me down, so I don't need to worry about that. And mixed with my muumuu, it just works out really, really well. Immediately, I grab a baby wipe. They always have them in the room. And I wipe down my hands, and then I wipe down my toes and in between my toes and on the sides of my feet. That is where I've found you can tell people get spray tans. So I'm always looking around and observing, and I just make sure that I really wipe the places where people can tell. I also like to wipe a little bit by my wrists, in between my fingers, all around the nails. Remember, I don't have a manicure yet, so that's working out well for me. And in between my toes. So after I get the baby wipe, I put my huge muumuu on, take the granny cap off, put my jewelry back on, and then I go to the bathroom and I wash my hands thoroughly. And I have found if you don't wash your hands, you will have Edward Scissorhands, but like with carrots on them. And like, you don't want that. So wash your hands afterwards. After I get a spray tan, I typically schedule a manicure, or what I like to call Lauren is running late, we gotta go, paint job. And that is where I go and I spend $5 and just get a polish change. But why you don't wanna get a manicure before you get the spray tan is because it will get in your cuticles a little bit. So you just wanna do the situation of the manicure after the spray tan. After the spray tan's done and I've done my paint job, I'm ready to go. I love how it looks. I try to leave it on for 8 hours. I just find that it really sets in. And if I have to sleep on it, like I have to, I lay a sheet down that's in our laundry room and just sleep on top of the sheet. That's not an ideal situation, but if you do have to sleep in the tan, make sure you have like an extra sheet that you found at Target or Home Goods and just lay it on top of your bed. For aftercare, you wanna make sure you're super hydrated, so make sure you find a lotion that you love. I have this one called Coconut Rose Lotion, and I just rub it all over my body before I go to bed because you don't wanna look like Magda from Something About Mary that's all crackled. It's just not a good situation. When you're hydrating your skin, try not to use oils afterwards for at least 3 days because it will take the tan off. Stick with lotions. Also, don't dry brush. You wanna wait 3 days to dry brush because it'll take the tan off. So I feel like I'm kind of a profesh when it comes to spray tanning, but if you guys have any other tips and tricks, I would love to know below. Thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure you hit the subscribe button. I feel like I'm doing like spray tan hands right now, and I'll see you next week.
Yeah, let it a honey sweet. Fill it up right when I eat. Rack on rack on rack. I got the hundreds on me. Jehovah who I don't know.
Michael's decided that he's finally gonna take up skincare. Is there a GG cracker in between my teeth? I got cracked by my chiropractor today. You see it on Snapchat. He almost ruined my spray tan, but we avoided that.